Hey guys, I want you guys to like this video if you're in need of money. So today I came across this video one of you guys sent me over on Twitter. And I gotta say, this is by far one of the craziest videos I have seen in a while. Apparently, there's a way to get unlimited money from an ATM. Watch the video, it was on the news, everything like that. It literally shows what to do and how these people are doing it. It's freaking crazy. I want this video to be shared. If you guys could share this with a friend, maybe that'd be awesome, because this is by far one of the craziest things I have seen in a while, and I didn't even know that this was possible. So let me just give you a little rough summary. There's a certain code you have to type in, the ATM, legit. It's just a certain code you type with the numbers, and it just starts withdrawing $10,000 at once. Literally a $10,000 little stack like this, and then another one, and then another one. It's insane. One of you guys sent me this over on Twitter. I thought it was freaking awesome, so I thought I would just show this in a video. Now, let me just point this out. This is just for educational purposes only, because the people that are doing this are actually getting caught. So don't do this, guys, all right? I'm being serious. This is not good. But this is actually one of the craziest videos I have seen in a while. Like, guaranteed, down pat, guaranteed one of the craziest videos I've freaking seen in a while, dude. All right, so with that being said, make sure you guys subscribe if you're new, like the video, make sure you guys share it, and check this shit out.
Independent automatic teller machines in the Chicago area. Investigators say they are using a special code that allows them to turn the machines into a source for free cash.
ABC7's Robbie Baseball is here with a story. Robbie?
Well, Ron, Cheryl, you know, ATM Systems out of Maryland is affected by all this, and they say that someone, likely with insider knowledge, passed codes to others that eventually led to people on Chicago streets being able to use those codes to tap independent ATMs for windfall amounts of cash. Now, individual accounts were not targeted in this spree. It ran from late December to late January, just a machine's ability to dole out the right kind of bills. Crime Stoppers says these three men are responsible for taking $140,000 from several ATMs in the downtown River North neighborhood. ATMs like this one, operated by ATM Systems out of Maryland, were victimized by crooks using master codes to access a machine's software and make it think it was dispensing $1 bills instead of $20 bills. For a $100 withdrawal and a generic gift card, say, that would mean 120s spilling out rather than 5. Crime Stoppers is offering a $1,000 reward for information leading to the arrest of any of these men.
We know that a couple of the pictures, people should be able to recognize who they are. Take a look at your neighbors, take a look at your co-workers. If you think you know who did this crime, call the 800 number.
Police and the ATM company stress no personal accounts were compromised. ATM Systems says affected machines were reset by the crooks so subsequent customers would experience the machine operating normally. Security consultant Joel Dubin works on ATM code issues with banks and says what happened with the independent machines is typical of how cybercrime is segmented.
You have like these organized criminal rings that are the professionals, the brains behind the whole thing. They're writing the code and doing all the hard work, and then they can give it to sort of the street level grunt that all they need to do is, here's the code, just go to the machine and do what you need to do.
ATM Systems acknowledges it has a problem with someone leaking critical codes. How much are you worried that your machines and your business is essentially the target of organized crime?
Very. I mean, it's a serious issue that's out there. It doesn't happen often, but obviously, you know, this is a huge loss.
What would be great to do is be able to find the person who did this, get them arrested, and find out, as I say, who's the teacher.
What do you say to those who say it's not safe to use independent banking machines?
I say that that's 100% not true.
Well, ATM Systems did call back several times as we were preparing this story to reiterate that last point, and also to say that they buy their machines from the same manufacturers that banks use. Now, the Illinois Bankers Association says that ATM fraud is everybody's concern, and they have been aware of the scam since 2006. And Ron and Cheryl, they say there's ATM software that these companies can use to really combat this kind of thing, and it really is a huge problem that they've known for a long time. And the bottom line here, though, is independent ATMs still are safe.
All right. Thanks, Robbie.
In a theatrical demonstration earlier this year, Barnaby Jack, director of research at IO Active Labs, showed how he could take control of an ATM and, among other things, make it spit out money. Here, Jack explains why and how he performed the stunt.
When you think of ATM security, you typically think about like physical security, right? Is the ATM bolted down properly? Are the cameras in place? You don't typically think about the actual underlying software on the ATM. So I figured it was about right time that someone actually pulled these things apart, looked at the software and see if there's any vulnerabilities there. And once I actually tore the lid off and found out how many vulnerabilities actually exist there, it was quite shocking in a way.
Jack used his discoveries to design two different attacks against standalone ATMs. Here he demonstrates them.
The first attack is a walk-up style attack. Now, all of these standalone ATMs, they ship with a master key. So this master key will open the top compartment, which allows access to the motherboard. It won't open the safe or anything like that. But this one key will open all the ATMs from that same manufacturer. Now that you have access to the motherboard, you can now update the software locally. So long as that software adheres to the correct format, the ATM will happily override its software with this new code. Now, of course, this new code will allow you to dump from the entire dispenser and do other nefarious deeds. And the other attack is the remote attack. Now, all of these standalone ATMs, they support remote management or remote configuration. So you can log into your ATM, change the splash screens, retrieve the settings, and all that type of thing. Generally, to be able to do this, you require a combination of passwords, a serial number, and what have you. I found a vulnerability which will allow me to bypass all of these passwords and then upload my own software onto the ATM remotely. And of course, my own software will capture credit card details, dump from the dispenser, and all that type of thing. And the worst part about this is these ATMs ship with this functionality enabled by default. And the reason they enable this functionality is so they can, is ironically enough, so they can ship security patches to these ATMs. It takes a specialized skill set to actually come up with these attacks. And for myself, it was about 8 months of fairly constant work. But I'm not naive enough to think that I'm the only person who could do this. And the thing is, with these type of attacks, it only takes one person to come up with that attack, and then they can distribute that software to whoever else. So it only takes one person to do it. At the moment, we haven't seen any of these exploits replicated, but it's certainly possible. At the moment, the ATM manufacturers have shipped patches to their ATMs, but of course, whether the actual ATM owners have applied those patches is a different story.
Hi guys. As college students, we're all a little tight on money, but we still have to eat, right? Today, we're gonna show you how to save a couple dollars by hacking a vending machine. Have you ever noticed on some vending machines there's a star and a pound key, but you don't really use them for anything? We're gonna show you how to make those work for your advantage. Let's check it out. This code is very important. This is how you're gonna get your refund on your money when you buy an item. So remember this code, star, star, pound, star, pound, star, pound. And I'm gonna insert my change. I think I'm gonna get some Fritos for 65 cents. There it goes. And I still got 65 cents.
Hey guys, we're back. We're here at a different vending machine. We're going to show you that these kind of hacks can be done on any vending machine. It doesn't matter what kind. The important thing to know is that they're just going to be different. The way these are handled is different. Different computers, different buttons, and that's what's important to know. On this machine, we're going to show you how to get a drink for pretty much free. Actually, it is free. You're going to trick the machine thinking that it has the money in there, that it's going to receive it, but really you're going to get all your money back. This kind of thing operates off of what's called a VMAC code. That's an acronym that stands for Vending Machine Master Access Code. The internals of this machine operate on a set program, and this one's from the Pepsi Corporation, so it's whatever they set it to, but fortunately we have the ability to do that right here. We know what it is. What you're going to want to do is you're going to start by entering your money. So each soda here costs $1.50, so I'm going to go ahead and enter that now. Okay, our money's been entered. The way it works is it works off of a sequence. So the machine's internals are actually operated on the first four buttons here. Think of it this way. Selection one is number one, selection two is number two, and so on and so forth. The code itself operates like this. You start with four, then two, then three, then one. You want to run through this two times. So we're going to do that right now. We go four, two, three, one. Then for the second time, four, two, three, one. At this point, you're ready to go. You're going to want to make your selection. We're going to select Mountain Dew. Hit the button. Come down here. It's been vended. And there you have it, a free soda. What's important now is you want to hit the coin return before the computer resets. As you can hear, your money's coming back out. All $1.50 of it. Just for a little visual for the cameras, you can see that we've got all our money back. All $1.50. Feel free to count it if you want, but it's all there. And that is how you hack a Pepsi vending machine. Hey guys, we're back yet again at a different vending machine. What you're gonna notice here with this one is that it's operating on the same keypad system that one of our previous machines did. So we're gonna use the same star pound VMAC code on this one. It's just like the old machine, so it's pretty much gonna be the same hack. So what we're gonna do is, once again, you're gonna get all your money back doing this, but we're gonna get a different item and it's a different machine. So for example, I want the Cinnamon Toast Crunch. I don't know why Cinnamon Toast Crunch sucks, but we're gonna get it. So what you're gonna wanna do is you're gonna come to the machine and you're gonna wanna enter your money. So it's a dollar. So I've entered my dollar. Then you're gonna wanna run through the sequence, which is star, star, pound, star, pound, star, pound. So here we go. Once we've done that, we're gonna wanna enter our item, which is F4. Okay, at this moment, you can see that we're getting all of our money back. Got a dollar in my hand and quarters, and a free Cinnamon Toast Crunch.